Today our topic is net operating income approach. This is the second capital structure theory, which is opposite of net income approach, which you have studied yesterday. So basically the theory was saying that the capital structure will affect the value of the firm and it will influence the cost of capital. Here we are saying change in capital structure will not influence cost of capital. Okay, so similarly here also value of the firm we have to find out, and value of equity and debt also we have to find out. One of the values, equity or debt, will be given in the problem and we have to find the other. Now what is the formula to calculate value of the firm? Value of the firm is equal to EBIT divided by overall cost of capital, that is addition of both the things. Now, value of equity is equal to value of firm minus value of debt. Now yesterday's problem we have done value of the firm is equal to value of equity plus value of debt. So similarly, same equation, it is simple equation formula. They have just transferred a value from here to there. Here it was positive, now it is negative. Okay. Now assumptions, like for yesterday it was that there were no taxes and all the other things, right? Now in the second approach, that is net operating income approach, you have two assumptions, that is no tax, tax will not be calculated, preference dividend is not there, okay, just like yesterday. And the second one is cost of capital is constant. That means in this particular problems, you need not calculate or you need not see whether it is increasing or decreasing. What is your capital, cost of capital? Cost of capital is nothing but the amount you pay back to the people from whom you have taken the amount. Yes or no? So what will happen here? It remains constant. Also, you need not calculate for both the things. It will come together in a problem. Fine. So let us do one problem so that it will be easy for you to understand. So here we are doing one problem. In the problem, it is given that operating income, that is EBIT. EBIT is also called as operating income, right? Is 2 lakh rupee. Cost of debt is 10% with 8 lakh rupees. If the overall capitalization rate is 12%, what would be the total value of the firm and equity capitalization rate? So till here, what we used to do, we used to calculate the value of the firm, yes or no, and we calculated debt in the last problem, value of the debt by deducting it, yes or no. So here what we are doing, value of the equity, sorry. So here what we are going to do is we are going to calculate value of the firm and equity capitalization rate. Like I told you, they will not be giving differently, that is separately for your debt and equity. It will be given together. Here they have given 12%, right? Similarly, what they will give? They will give it for together, that is both the equities, that is the sources of funds, and then you have to deduct one to get the another. Fine. So here we'll see how to do the problem. You know how to calculate value of the firm, right? Value of the firm is EBIT divided by K naught. K naught is what? Overall capitalization rate. What is the capitalization rate given? 12%. What is your EBIT? Is 2 lakh rupees. Can you calculate value of the firm? Yes. So 2 lakhs divided by 12% is how much? 16,66,667. So what is happening here? Value of the firm is already done. Very, very easy. Don't get confused. See, value of the firm, to find out value of the firm in net operating income approach, the formula is EBIT divided by K naught. So EBIT is given in the problem, that is 2 lakhs rupees, and overall cost of capital is 12%. So if you do on your calculator 2 lakh rupees divided by 12%, your answer will be 16,66,667. So here what they have said, first part of the problem is done. Second part is equity capitalization rate. For that, first you have to calculate value of the equity. How do you calculate value of equity? When you deduct the value of the firm minus your value of the debt, you will get your equity. Yes or no? So here, what is the value of the debt? This is value of the firm given to you. Now you know what is the value of the firm on a whole, because they are saying there are only two types of sources, that is debt and equity. So its value is 16,66,667. Now they are saying value of the debt is given in the problem. Yes, it is given. 8 lakhs is given to you, right? Are you given with the value of the equity? No, that we have to find out, and also we have to find out the percentage. That is the percent of amount we will be giving to them every year. So how to find out that? From the whole, that is value of the firm, you are deducting value of the debt to get value of equity. So 16,66,607 minus 8 lakhs. Why 8 lakhs? Because value of the firm is 8 lakhs rupees. So your answer is 8,66,667. This is what? This is value of equity. So what we have calculated? We have calculated value of the firm. We have calculated value of equity. Next, what we have to calculate? We have to calculate equity capitalization rate. So how do you get that equity capitalization rate? First, what we did not do over here is because we did not require, we did not do that for the first step, that is value of the firm. But here actually you will be deducting the interest amount on debt. No, we forgot that. So here what you have to do? EBIT is 2 lakh rupee, interest 10% on 8 lakhs. That is the EBIT minus interest that you calculate for your debt, 80,000 rupees. So now your EBT is 1,20,000 rupees. Next, how to calculate capitalization rate for equity? EBT divided by value of equity. Value of equity is already found out, no? We have found out the value of equity. Now EBT is how much? After deduction of the interest from your EBIT, it is 1,20,000. So 1,20,000 divided by 8,66,667. Your answer is 13.85%. Now what is happening over here? 13.85% you are paying for how much amount? 8,66,667 rupees, which you have taken from the outsiders. And for 8 lakhs rupees, you are paying 10% of the amount every year. So that is what we wanted to calculate through net operating income approach. Now basically in net operating income approach, what do they give? They give you EBIT, they give you the percentage of debt and value of the debt. You are supposed to find out the equity value, value of the firm and equity capitalization rate. Formula to calculate value of the firm is EBIT divided by overall capitalization rate, that is together. Then you will get the value of your equity. Then you will do your equity capitalization rate. Yes, so it is very, very simple. Now this is your homework problem. Here they have given EBIT as 2 lakhs. Cost of debt is 10 lakhs rupees. 10% is the interest per year. K naught is what? K naught is nothing but the value of the cost that you give, overall cost, that is equity plus your debt, how much you pay per year. That is 12% value of the firm and equity capitalization rate we have to find out. So what is the formula? First, you will be calculating market value. So what is market value? How do you calculate? EBIT divided by K naught. Do we have EBIT? Yes, we have EBIT as 2 lakhs and your K naught is 12%. That is the overall cost of capital. So 2 lakhs divided by 12%, how much is the amount? You have to find out. Next, value of debt. Value of debt is how much already given, right? 10 lakh rupees. Next, we have to find out the market value of equity. How do you find out market value of equity? Market value, yes, minus market value of the debt. So whatever amount you get over here minus your 10 lakh rupees will be your market value of equity. Next, equity capitalization rate. How do you calculate the rate? First, you have to complete the first step, that is EBIT, and deduct the interest rate. Interest rate is almost 10 lakhs. Into 10% will be your interest rate. So you will deduct that from your 2 lakh rupees. So 10% of 10 lakhs is how much? 10,000 rupees. 10,000 rupees, 2 lakhs minus 10,000 rupees. Sorry, it is 1 lakh. So 2 lakhs minus 1 lakh is 1 lakh rupee. And your market value of equity, how do you find out? After completing this step, you will get your market value of equity. So 2 lakh rupees minus your interest amount, that is 10 lakhs into 10% is 1 lakh. So 2 minus 1 divided by market value of equity, you will get your equity capitalization rate.